I think I'm really lucky as a researcher because we discover new things that nobody has ever seen before on, I wouldn't say on a daily basis, but you know, several times a month, I guess, we have something that nobody else has seen or researched before, right? So it's very rewarding. I originally studied zoology in Europe, in Vienna, and then I got the postdoc position in the US. And that's where I really got into microbiology. After that, I took a year off, and my wife and I fixed up an old sailboat. And we sailed across the Pacific, and we were on one island. It was an uninhabited island, the Tuamotus. There are so many of them. And we stayed there for a week. We enjoyed it, snorkeling, called it our island. But then we did realize there's some small plastic debris there, right? And then we actually investigated that, and we said, okay, we're going to clean up this island. And we came back with like two large garbage bags of plastic. And that's when my interest got really kindled into, you know, well, we have to do something about the plastic crisis, right? The plastic waste crisis that we have. The idea was to look into options for a biological degradation of plastics. And in particular, we looked at polystyrene. And we looked into an insect, the superworm. So I should say the superworm, the name is worm. Officially, it's called a superworm. It's actually an insect larvae. And we used those superworms to show that they can actually degrade polystyrene. And what was surprising or good for us was that they could survive on it and even gain a little bit of weight during our experiments. So what we want to do is to create an artificial superworm. So to first mechanically degrade the plastic, the polystyrene, and then use the enzymes to further break it down. There are a lot of solutions to our problems out there in nature, but we have to understand how nature works. We have to learn from it, and we have to then implement that. You know, everybody wants to contribute to live on a safe and clean planet. And I think as a scientist, as a microbiologist, we can do our part to achieve that.